we're going to talk about lasers. We're going to talk about what lasers are, how they work, some different types of lasers, and some safety aspects that we need to take into account when ever working with a laser. So basically, to start off, laser is an acronym. It stands for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Okay, so it's not really a word, but it's an acronym. Basically, the basic principle of how a laser works is an excitation mechanism is the source of energy to a laser. That excitation mechanism provides energy to the active medium, and then that energy is then used to produce a laser output beam. Next, we're going to have a diagram up on the board and show you what I was talking about.
As follows previously, we have a basic diagram of the components of a laser. We have the excitation mechanism, which activates your medium, and the medium produces energy, which is reflected by these mirrors. This one's a highly reflective mirror, so everything's reflected by this partial reflective mirror. That allows everything in the laser to be outputted, or not everything, but parts of it. This is known as the optical cavity, this whole thing. Also, the excitation mechanism could either be another laser powered by an electrical source or even be a light source. The active medium dictates what type of laser you have, whether it's a gas laser or solid state lasers.
Lasers differ from ordinary light in three different ways. First, lasers are monochromatic. That means they're going to be one color and have one wavelength, or some lasers might even have a very, very small range of wavelengths. Lasers are going to be directional. They're not going to spread out or diverge like regular light does. They're going to stay on its path. And then also, lasers exhibit coherence, which means they're all in phase. Basically, this can be, demonstrated by saying this is a laser right here. This is its output. It's going to be, monochromatic. It's red. It's one wavelength. It's very directional, and then it's going to point this way. It's not going to spread out. It doesn't diverge at all. It has a very low divergence. And then also, it's going to be very irradiance right here at this point. There's going to be a high concentration of power hitting, say, just this is a wall. So that is how lasers are different than regular light in three different ways. Now we're going to talk about a few different types of lasers. The first type of laser we're going to talk about is a gas laser. Now gas lasers, there's all different kinds. We're going to kind of talk about two specific examples. The first example of a gas laser can be the helium neon laser. That is basically the first gas laser that was invented in the 60s. It was actually the first laser that was actually continuous operation and not pulse. The helium neon laser is capable of a wide range of applications, and it's very versatile in what it's used for, and it actually produces infrared light. Another type of laser, gas laser, is the excimer laser. And basically, the excimer laser is two species, consists of two species that would not be found together in a ground state, but they are electronically excited, and they come together and form a short-lived dimer. And that dimer actually produces UV light, and that is what makes the laser beam have the light that comes out of it. A few interesting applications are in LASIK surgery. The laser that they actually use is actually an excimer laser. The next type of laser we're going to talk about today is the solid-state laser. Basically, what makes a solid-state laser different is that the active medium of a solid-state laser is a solid. Usually, it's found to be a glass or a crystalline of some sort. Solid-state lasers are excited by using an optical source. So it's either excited by a flash lamp, arc lamp, or a laser diode. Lastly, laser diodes, they're going to be more efficient, and that's going to be what's found in the newer solid-state lasers. One of the most common solid-state lasers is this laser, and it's the neodymium doped yttrium aluminum garnet, so that's what that stands for. It's the most common solid-state laser. It's used extensively in manufacturing. It's used for etching, cutting, welding steel. We're going to talk about some laser safety. Basically, lasers are classified five different ways. We've got a class 1 laser, class 2 laser, class 3A, class 3B, and then class 4. Class 1 and 2 lasers really don't cause that much damage to anything. They're really low powered. The radiation that comes off of them really isn't that damaging. Class 3A is where your lasers are between 1 to 5 milliwatts output, and that's where you start getting corneal damage if you look straight into that laser. So never look into a class 3A, really never look into any laser directly. So that's your class 3A. Class 3B is where you start getting into your medium power lasers. Those are going to be closely monitored and watched, and class 3B lasers basically can cause very severe eye damage and also can start to cause skin damage if you get in the way of the laser. And then class 4 lasers are very, very high powered lasers. They're closely watched and monitored by different agencies, and those lasers are very damaging to your eyes, so definitely never look into those, and they're also damaging to your skin.
This is going
to
be your standard laser pointer that you might find a teacher using in class or something like that in a presentation. Basically, this is just a close-up of the laser warning label, and is, I don't know if you can see, but this laser is actually a class 3A laser, which means it's between 1 and 5 milliwatt output, and it's basically a single wavelength. The wavelength of this laser is 654 nanometers, and now basically I'm just going to give you all a demonstration of what this laser can do.
Basically, if you see on this wall, you know, you're getting a red dot. This basically is your laser beam right here. And pretty much the one safety precaution to take with a laser like this is to never look in directly into it, and don't shine it straight up into the air, or you might blind pilots when you're flying in the sky. And that basically will conclude our little talk about lasers. Hope you enjoyed, and hope you learned some interesting facts about lasers.